3, 2, 1.
Wet plate collodion was one of the first techniques ever created to shoot images. In order to learn more about this technique, I went to Vienna, Austria to meet Marcus, a great wet plate photographer. We did different wet plates, so I'm going to show you the process and the best ones.
Hi guys, my name is Markus Hofstetter. I'm a wet plate artist from Austria, and today we're gonna shoot some wet plates on 100-year-old cameras.
Just watch your head. Just here, doing the developing and filling the plate holders, and here is my pulling room. So that's the room where I'm pouring the plates. It's two rooms away from the studio, so it doesn't smell that bad in the studio. It's just...
It's strong.
Yeah, it's strong, hot.
So we're prepared. We're gonna shoot with that camera today, outside. I totally modified this plate holder. It's important that you put the plate in, like the silver nitride have to cover it with one big wave. If it's covering it like at this point first, and then at this point you get like some texture on it you don't want. And now I have here my pouring bottle and fresh made collodion. It's just 1 week old. Put it here. So now comes the smelly stuff. Just dropping the plate so I don't get any stains, because it's drying now and it would go down during the drying process and it would make lines. Yeah, that's pretty okay. In this process now it's transforming into silver salts. I let it drop a little bit. It's like milky, if you see that. It's this milky. So put it in the plate holder. Like that and put your arm here. Yeah.
Right. Super. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, perfect.
Ready?
Okay.
Three, two, one.
Thanks, that's it.
Put the develop on.
Zwanzig, 22. Oh, it's super bright.
It looks good, I think.
So, now we go outside and we have a look. I think because it's pretty hot, it gets another color, but I think it's a little bit too bright still.
Yeah, but it's really cool. The bouquet behind is
yeah, looks nice.
So crazy.
All the people like to have all the dirt on the plate because it looks so cool and looks so old, but I try to make it like perfect as I can make it. When photography started to evolve, to get more and more popular, all the painters were like, the photographers are all, what's the English word for it, like people who have no clue about posing, no clue about light, they're just making pictures. I only do 1 second, I do really a short one now. 3, 2, 1. Thanks.
So, looks good to me, let's see.
Still have a little bit of swirly bouquet in the background. I think this is much more contrasty now. It's pretty good now. I think this is from the exposure, it's good. You have still a little bit swirly. But we're gonna shoot now with the bigger one inside.
Super, that's it.
Maybe it's too bright. Let's see. Your face is sharp. I think the expression is super cool. The magician.
Yeah,
magician.
The fact that you see the string, it makes it even more like, you know, do it yourself.
Yeah, yeah,
man.
Yeah, sure.
Photoshop.
I like also the fact that these cameras are really old, so I think they would have they would tell some interesting stories. And this is actually a film holder from the Fujifilm, from the pillar part, and we put a bed plate in there. It's just that you get an idea how you move your hand. It's super difficult, more difficult than inside because it's water. It has not the same tension then. Yeah, just try to walk it from one corner to the next one. Yeah, only with one hand. It's super difficult with water with yeah, like that. You will see it's super easy inside.
Safety is number one priority. I feel like I'm serial killer.
Yeah, a little bit more. So, in this direction a little bit, and back here, back in the bottle. Yeah, super, perfect. Try to rock it a little bit, to move it, like that. That's it. Now we have to wait for 3 minutes. Just look through the viewfinder. We do first a picture of Matthew, maybe with a funny face, then I sit there and make a funny face.
Okay.
Like that, I think.
So it's 2 photos each.
So. Just here, put it in.
It's kind of
It's coming.
You're pretty clean too.
Yeah, that's cool.
Pour that on. I can use that again. I'm just scared if the flames came out and could go campfire out now. It's a lot of
oh.
I told you. Yeah. Let's see how shiny it is afterwards. Mm. It's really cool.
If you enjoyed the video, then visit my wetlit channel on YouTube. And if you want to experience to make a wetlit by yourself, you can just contact me on my website and book a workshop at my studio. Ha ha.